The job of president is far more difficult than we even imagine. It makes me, being a member of Congress or Supreme Court justice even, look almost easy by comparison. The decisions are incredibly difficult. The pressure is relentless. The problems never go away. There's no recess. There's no summer break. You're always on. And at the end of the day, only one person is responsible for those decisions. You don't have eight other colleagues like you do on the Supreme Court, or 99 other colleagues like you do in the Senate, or 434 other colleagues as in the House of Representatives. As president, and I really came to understand this, it's you and only you. There's no one else to point to when things go wrong, and there's no one else who ultimately can make the final decision. We revere the presidency in this country, and even then, though, I think we grossly underestimate how difficult it is. There's a great book at the end of the Clinton presidency by John Harris, who was a Washington Post reporter, about President Clinton called The Survivor. And I think that term really, after being staff secretary, captures well what the presidency entails, I think, for any president in this day and age. So having seen how difficult the job is, I think it's important that we think about how we can structure the system so that the president's able to focus on his never-ending task with as few distractions as possible. And with that in mind, it seems to me that it's one first proposal I'd have is that Congress take action to alter the result in the Clinton versus Jones case. The Clinton versus Jones case, as you'll recall, allowed a civil suit to proceed against the president while he's in office. And the result the court reached in that case, the Supreme Court, may well have been the right result as a matter of constitutional law. That's really not for me to say. But the court indicated that Congress could always provide for a temporary deferral of civil suits against the president. And I think there's no good reason that Congress should not do so. To be sure, this may not seem like an urgent issue, but it's in separation of powers, it's important to see around the corner, to see what the issues that could arise in the future are. And in my judgment, it would make a good deal of sense for Congress to make sure that a situation that occurred in 1998 with the Clinton versus Jones case and then the resulting criminal investigation doesn't occur again while a president is in office. If you think about it, during 1998, that's when President Clinton ordered in August attacks on Osama bin Laden in August of 1998, and it was just a couple days, he did that just a couple days after his grand jury testimony about the Monica Lewinsky matter. When you think back on that, and you think about the country's priorities, and you think what prompted that in the first place, it really makes sense to make sure as a country that we give our president as much room as possible to operate free from the usual burdens of the citizenry.